girl. Evening.
Good evening.
You should be careful who you speak to around here. Just take care now, right?
Take care now. Well, I'm glad that's over. Would you please just get out of here?
Just minding my own business.
I need you to leave.
I ain't here to cause trouble.
Help! Help! The law will hear about this.
Excuse me, ma'am.
I'm just gonna leave. Oh, hell.
You should just walk away from this lady.
Is there a lawman nearby? Why are you doing this? Please.
And all right, then. Go look into it right now.
I don't
know. I'm getting the law.
Just go.
Just leave me alone!
I said stop, damn it.
Karen!
You did the right thing. I'll have men on it right away.
Come on, girl.
Evening. You got issues with me?
Evening, sir.
Ooh. Oh, you poor bastard.
Abigail, you deserve so much more than I can manage. This, I just don't know much about fathering.
Oh, it's real easy.
What do I do?
You did good in town, finding out about that train.
Thank you. It was fun.
Well, I wouldn't say it was all fun.
Just like your mama did? Raise a real man? But it's not what I imagined. Without the hunt, it's not really anything. I don't want to simply carry things across the sea. I want to pull things from it. So I, too, go west. And soon I fall into some terrible trouble with some really bad men I meet. They force me to marry a woman so they can steal all my money. But...
Okay there, Dutch?
You all right?
Yeah. When are you going to meet Trelawney and the others? If there's a chance to get to Sean.
I know. I'm on it, I promise.
Morning, Arthur.
Hold still, girl. Yeah, there, girl.
You done good, girl. Okay, then, girl.
Keep your eyes open, Bill.
Good morning, Arthur.
Mister, help!
Hey, shut up. Get out of here. Act like you never saw this.
Hey, just thought you might need some help was all, okay?
Shit, it is. Arthur Morgan himself.
Hey, you think you're a dime novel?
Mister, I don't hardly know what to say. Thanks, I guess. You done me a service. Hey, look, the stage company's gonna write this off as a robbery anyway. If you can get in that lockbox, you can take what you want from it. It ain't stealing if it's already stolen.
Got that right.
Hey there.
Hello?
Getting out of the damn way!
Morning.
Oh. Hello. Quite a day, isn't it?
Sure.
What a country. I'm working on a project. Photography.
Yeah, I guess that bit.
Of course. Wildlife. That's my thing. Well, that's what I want to be my thing. If I have to take another picture of a grumpy housefrau or pompous middle-class burger, I will feed myself to the lions. Stand here.
Here?
Just there. Albert Mason.
Arthur Morgan.
Pleasure. I'm trying to find and capture images of our great predators before our greatest predators kill them all and stick them on some clubhouse wall.
Good luck with that.
Yes, not the easiest. But, well, I love a challenge. The trick is to leave a big load of meat and relax and pray they don't mistake me for lunch. Oh! Good heavens! My bag! That thing is robbing me! Oh, good heavens!
Don't worry. That thing is a coyote. Sneaky one, too. Wildlife photographer. Coming back. Your bag.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, sir.
A bag full of meat will tend to bring out the worst in the local population.
You are a gentleman. The bag also had a lot of my supplies. You've saved me days. I can't thank you enough. Thank you.
Don't worry about it.
You take care, sir.
I ain't the one trying to get myself eaten.
I realize I am a fool. Forgive me. And thank you very much once again.
Move!
Trelawney.
Who knows?
Just keep your eyes open.
I am.
Hey.
Hey.
Where is that little Irish pest?
I'm not quite sure. Trelawney's off trying to find out.
Has anyone been in the Blackwater, see how things lie?
Place is crawling with Pinkertons, bounty hunters, and pictures of Dutch and Hosea.
We got a lot of money sitting in that town.
And that's where it's gonna remain for now.
Why haven't they hanged Sean, I wonder?
I think he's bait. Or they want to trial him publicly.
Gentlemen, Sean is being moved up the upper Montana, then to a federal prison out west.
Damn. We can't be rescuing people from some federal prison. We either rescue him now or cut him loose.
We're not cutting anyone loose.
Of course not.
Ike Skelding's boys are moving him to a camp nearby before handing him over to the government.
So, I guess we need to stop them before they get to camp. Charles, why don't you head up on the north side? And we'll head up on the other side of the valley and meet you. That way we have them in either direction. Javier, Josiah, come on. Let's go see.
You know, Arthur, the government, or people whom the government like, seem to be very angry.
Sure. Well, we'll rescue Sean and then we'll get ourselves lost, good and proper. It's a big country.
I hope so.
Let's go, girl. Shh, girl. Follow me. Let's see if we can track down this boat.
Keep your eyes open for Pinkertons. They got patrols out all over this area.
Yes. South of the river, West Elizabeth isn't a very welcoming place right now.
Down there. Reckon those might be our boys.
Another war.
You think they can see us?
If they can, we're just three fellas out on the trail. Act natural. We'll be fine.
So, you've been gone for a while.
Much as I love dodging the law and sleeping in the dirt with you derelicts, I do have other business to attend to.
What happened to New York?
You know how life is. Never a straight road anywhere.
Especially with you.
Nice to know I'm missed, though. Have you run out of people to rob?
Oh, we'll never run out of people to rob.
Come on, let's keep them in sight.
You all right, Javier? You're quiet.
He hasn't stopped talking since we left you in Valentine. It's the longest ride of my life.
Cute, dear boy. Very cute. Push up, come on. Apparently, there's a camp somewhere around here where the bounty hunters meet and transfer before continuing out west. I imagine that's where they're headed. Stopped. All right, let's take a closer look. Binoculars. Gentlemen.
So who are these bounty hunters?
I don't know too much about Ike Skelton's boys, but I hear they're a big crew, wild, built some reputation in the last year or two.
That looks like Sean to me.
Certainly kicking up enough of a fuss. Yep, that's definitely Sean.
Oh, they're giving him a decent kicking.
Well, you can only imagine the shit he's been giving them.
Oh, yes.
They're taking him up the canyon.
There's Charles on the other side. Let's go.
What about the other two down there?
I've got an idea. Follow me.
Can.
Leave it to me, gentlemen. I'll go around and create a distraction. Then you two sneak across and do the dirty on them.
Okay. Crouch down out of sight. Take out your knife. Stay here. Okay, let's move down. Don't cross until he's got their attention. Reeling them in.
Gentlemen! Excuse me. Dear brothers, my wife is taken ill. Gravely ill.
What's the problem?
It's dear Bessie.
You take the one on the left. Mary's Let's go now. Keep down.
I'm beside myself. If I lose Bessie, I lose everything.
Oh, calm down, mister.
I can't. I'm having a fit.
Okay, let's get after him.
A pleasure, as always, gentlemen. I think you have it from here.
Two halfway up the canyon to deal with.
Qué lindo boots you got there, eh? Well, they're very nice. Who's the guy you got them from? Is he alive still?
Where did these sons of bitches come from?
crouch down out of sight. Take out your knife.
Wait.
Until he's got them off guard before crossing. Wait here.
Gentlemen.
He's still reeling them in.
Excuse me. Dear brothers, my wife is taken ill. Gravely ill.
What's the problem?
It's dear Bessie. She's taken a turn.
Where is she?
A terrible turn.
Stay low.
I'm beside myself. If I lose Bessie, I lose everything!
Oh, calm down, mister.
I can't! I'm having a fit!
Come on, let's get up there.
A pleasure, as always, gentlemen. I think you have it from here.
We got two halfway up the canyon to deal with. Come on! You got to watch these sons of bitches! Charles, you go right, okay?
I guess.
Let's get Sean and get
Arthur. You know, you're a lot less ugly from that other angle, Arthur.
Come on.
Do we get a hug, Arthur? A warm embrace for a lost brother now found.
You know, nothing means more to me than this gang, the bond we share. It's the most real thing to me. I would kill for it, I would happily die for it. But in spite of all of that, I would have easily left you here to rot if Charles hadn't stopped me.
I don't believe a word of that, Arthur.
Get him out of here.
You're a great man, Arthur Morgan. The kind of young whippersnapper can really admire. Oh,
shut up. Right, we should split up. Javier, will you escort Mr. McGuire back to camp? Charles, best you ride separately. Be careful. There's patrols everywhere.
What about you?
I'm gonna see what's worth taking here. I'll meet you back there as soon as I can.
All right.
Okay, come on.
Have I got stories for you?
Yeah, I can't wait.
I imagine y'all miss me a lot. But fear not, the joy's back in your lives now.
Greetings. Good to see you. Ready for a clean slate? Traveling mercies to you.
My girl.
Yep. good girl?
Been a while.
You ain't the hell is wrong with you? Out of the way!
Be careful there.
You ain't been through in a while. Have a look around. That's done. Food kept airtight or best thing to have on hand. Okay, then. All right. Enjoy. Good doing business with you. All right, then, let's have a look. Uh-huh.
Let me have a look.
Appreciate it. Nice. Would you look at the color on that? Enjoy. It's all yours. Thank you. Okay, then. Good doing business with you. Nice. All right. Enjoy.
That should be good. Thanks, partner.
Hello there.
Howdy. New in town? Gum? Candies, tobacco, all the good stuff are on the shelves behind my counter. Tonics and medicines are on the table over there. Everything else, you should see the catalog. Well, let's see what you got. All right, anything good?
Greetings.
Oh, wait. You're that fellow who had to fight with Tommy outside of Smithfield's?
Yep.
People are still talking about that fight.
I ain't.
Fair enough. Neither's Tommy. Anyway, how can I help you today? This goddamn place is rotten to the
Crawford to Carmel.
Thanks for your assistance.
Our very own avenging angel. Look on the wall there if you're after another quarry.
Well, looks like trouble, all right.
That one? They say she's sleeping rough near Cumberland Falls.
Oh, it's, you.
Yes, it is. Last time I checked.
I really don't need any more trouble.
I didn't come to make any. I was just protecting a lady.
Well, all behind us now, I suppose. So what is it you need? A bath, perhaps?
Would you like some extra help there?
Oh, sounds good. Yeah, thanks.
You can just leave it to me now. Let me know if you'd like a bit of an extra scrub anywhere. I'll be out of your hair in no time.
Sorry for smell. Been a while.
Oh, I'm not sure what to make of that.
Been a while since I've been able to relax like this.
Well, then.
Okay, I don't think I'm gonna get much cleaner than this. Thank you.
All the best.
Excuse me.
Oh, very funny.
Hello, ma'am. Beg your pardon, ma'am.
Oh, okay. Not to worry.
Come on. Here for the show?
What's playing?
The Bear.
Mm-hmm.
I need a ticket, please.
Right then, just head inside the tent.
Morality tale from when our country was young that the settlers used to tell about the woods of Massachusetts and the creatures that lived there. One summer, a bear was by the stream, and Old Man Wind appeared and said, "Bear, I shall blow a mighty cold upon the land. Engorge yourself on fish and meat and go find a den. Then sleep, not for one night, but for 60. Go tell all the animals of the forest what I have told you." Bear was sad because the fish were his friends, and now he had to eat them. But he knew to do whatever the wind told him. The animals of the forest often teased Bear and said he was slow and lazy and foolish for listening to Old Man Wind. "You're talking to the wind again, eh?" laughed the rabbit. "I think Bear has finally taken leave of his senses," said the turtle, "and he's getting so rotund that even I could outrun him." "I'm smart and quick," said Rabbit. "I'll outrun Old Man Wind if he comes a-calling, or you, since you're into eating your friends." The turtle said, "If Wind comes, I'll just hide in my shell." Then Bear went and warned Coyote and Possum that they should prepare for a long, cold winter. "It's so hot," said the coyote. "There's plenty of time."
Oh, dear. Didn't like the show?
Chunky needs a nap.